Good evening, race fans. Before I start today's video of the Atlanta Motorsports Car Track, just want to thank you guys so much to tune in each and every week for my broadcast for all the different leagues we cover. All-American, ARCA, Legacy Sports Cars, FEGPC.net, 100% Cup Series, League Zero, the Team Goon Squad Street Stock Pro Series. Thank you all so much to all of you guys, the Original Rebel Racing League guys. I'm sure I'm forgetting a couple more, so if I am, my sincerest apologies. But thank you guys so much that tune in each and every week. I am proud to announce, as of next week, I will be officially self-employed thanks to broadcasting East Action Sports, as well as a contractor gig I just picked up. So looking forward to the future. Keep an eye out for more real-life racing shenanigans that'll be posted out here on the Team Goon Squad YouTube channel. And thank you guys that join the Discord and support me all the time. I couldn't do it without you. Right now, we're out in the old workshop for East Action Sports, parting some stuff out, trying to make some money turning junk into gold. But again, thank you guys, and enjoy the next video, and hope to see you in the next one as well. Thank you. All right, guys, thanks for tuning in. Today we're at Atlanta Motorsports Park, and I do some onboard shenanigans with my GoPro Hero 7. I'm out here on track with the lovely Maggie Hayden right in front of me with her Venom-painted HJC helmet. Now, the intent for today was to go out and try and click off some practice laps for an upcoming 8-hour endurance race. I can't remember if it's an 8-hour or a 10-hour endurance race with a good friend of mine, Philip Baker. But unfortunately, the race was canceled due to some track logistics. Apparently, somebody cut through the live timing cables that they use for the transponders. So today, we weren't able to use transponders like you normally would for a racetrack. And instead, we're having to rely with the onboard GoPro stuff. But for the most part, it seems like the Hero 7, I mean, it clicks off really good quality footage. And it also does a fairly good job of acting as a transponder with the built-in GPS. Now, comparing the lap timer you can see on the left side of your screen compared to actually timing the lap if you have your cell phone out or a stopwatch, it seems like the GoPro is anywhere about a half to three quarters of a second off either way per lap. Some laps it reads fast, some laps it reads slow. But overall, very impressed with the quality of the footage as well as the built-in features. But I'm going to let you guys just ride on board. Here's two different sessions of Maggie and I out there hot lapping. And you'll see the track will start to dry up towards the end of it. But right now it is very, very wet, and we're just doing our best to hold on to it. One final note I want to point out before I quit talking is that there's not supposed to be any passing under the opening lap of the session, the full course caution. I don't think Maggie really cared about that, and she immediately went back out there and started sending it. But thank you guys for tuning in, and here's a few laps on board at Atlanta Motorsports Park with the rental car sessions. Thank you, guys.